ராமாய ராமபத்ராய ராமச்சந்திராய வேதசே ரகுநாத் ஹாய நாத் ஹாய சீதாய பதி ஏ நமக. உத்தரகாண்ட் சாப்டர் நம்பர் 6, ப்ரெப்பரேஷன் ஃபார் த பேட்டில் அகேன்ஸ்ட் விஷ்ணு. தி ரெசிடேஷன் பிகின்ஸ் நவ். Thus afflicted, the deities, sages, ascetics, wrought up with fear, sought the protection of that god of gods, Maheshwara, creator and destroyer of the cosmos, unborn of an unmanifest form, the stay of all creatures, worthy of being adored, and the supreme preceptor of all. And coming to that enemy of Kama and foe of Tripura, the three-eyed deity, the gods with voices faltering through fear, represented with joined hands and said, O reverend one, the creatures of the lord of creatures are being sorely troubled by the sons of Sukesha, given to harassing their foes, swollen with insolence on account of the boon conferred on them by the great father. Our asylums constituting our refuges have been divested of their powers of granting shelter, and driving off the deities from the ethereal regions, they are sporting there like the immortals. I am Vishnu, I am Rudra, I am the king of celestials, I am Yama, I am Varuna, I am the moon, I am the sun. Flattering themselves in this fashion, Mali, Sumali and the Rakshasa Malyavan, as well as those going before them, are annoying the gods, breathing exhilaration of martial spirits. Therefore, O God, it behooveth thee to liberate us from fear, who have been greatly tormented by it. Do thou, assuming thy terrible form, slay the thorns of the celestials. Thus addressed by the immortals in a body, that Lord Kapardi of red-blue hue, reflecting that it would be wrong for him to destroy Sukesha with his own hands, spoke unto the gods. I shall not slay them, ye gods, they are incapable of being slain by me. But I shall unfold unto you the way in which they will be destroyed. Do ye Maharshis, in the heat of this affair, seek the shelter of Lord Vishnu. That Lord will slay them. Thereat, saluting Maheshwara with the sounds of Jaya, the celestials, afflicted with the fear of the night rangers, presented themselves before Vishnu. And bowing down unto the Lord, holding the conch, discus and the mace, and paying him high homage, they, greatly flurried, addressed him about the sons of Sukesha, and said, O God, by virtue of the boon that hath been bestowed on them, resembling the three fires, Sukesha's three sons assailing us, have deprived us of our abode. There is a city named Lanka, stationed on the top of Mount Trikuta, which is extremely difficult to enter. Taking up their station at that place, the night rangers in a body pursue us. We have sought thy shelter. Please become our refuge, O foremost of celestials. Do thou dedicate to Yama the lotuses of their faces, severed in pieces with thy discus. Save thee, we have none who can, while tormented with fright, inspire us with courage. Slay in encounter the elated Rakshasas along with their adherents, and even as the sun drieth up dew, do thou dispel this fear of ours. Thus accosted by the deities, that god of gods, Lord Janardhana, who bringeth fear unto foes, cheering up the celestials, said unto them, I know the Rakshasa Sukesha as flushed with the boon bestowed by Ishana, and I also know his sons, of whom Malyavan is the oldest. Those worst of Rakshasas that have overridden your dignity will I, wrought up with wrath, slay in battle. Therefore, ye gods, be of good cheer. Thus addressed by the mighty Vishnu, the gods, highly rejoiced, went to their respective quarters, extolling Lord Janardhana. And hearing of the activity of the celestials, the night ranger Malyavan addressed his heroic brothers, saying, The immortals and sages going to Shankara spake these words, desirous of our destruction. The terrific sons of Sukesha, puffed up and swollen on account of their strength, flowing from the boon, are crossing us at every step. We have been overpowered by the Rakshasas. And, O Lord of creatures, from fear of those wicked-minded ones, we cannot remain in our own homes. Therefore, to do us good, do thou, O three-eyed one, destroy them. And, O best of consuming ones, do thou with thy roars burn them up. Thus addressed by the deities, the slayer of Andhaka, hearing their speech, said, shaking his heads and hands, Ye gods, Sukesha's sons are incapable of being slain by me in battle, but I shall tell you the means whereby they may be slain. Do ye seek the shelter of him who holdeth the discus and mace in his hands, and who is clad in a yellow attire, of Janardana, Hari, even of the auspicious Narayana. Having received this counsel of Hara, they, rendering reverence unto that enemy of Kama, came to the abode of Lord Narayana and communicated everything unto him. Then Narayana spoke unto the celestials with Indra at their head, I will slay those foes of the celestials. Ye gods, cast off all fear. O foremost of Rakshasas, Hari promised unto the frightened celestials that he would slay us. Therefore, do a thing as to what is fit. Hiranyakashipu hath met the death at the hands of Hari, as also other enemies of the immortals. And Namuchi and Kalanimi and that foremost of heroes, Sankhrada and Radheya and Bahumai and the virtuous Lokapala and Yamala and Arjuna and Hardikya and Shumba and Nishumbaka, Asuras and Danavas endowed with strength and possessed of terrific powers, all these who have come to the field have never been heard of as worsted, who had performed hundreds of sacrifices, who had been well skilled in illusion, who had been versed in every branch of knowledge, and who were the terrors of their foes, have by hundreds and by thousands been destroyed by Narayana. Learning this, it behooveth you to do what would conduce to the behoof of all. It is a sore task to defeat Narayana, who wisheth to slay us. Thereat, Somali and Mali, hearing the words of Malyavan, said unto the eldest brother, like the Ashwins addressing Vasava, We have studied, performed sacrifices, practiced charity and obtained riches, and attaining long health and long life, we have established sterling righteousness in our path. And our arms plunging into the sea of celestials, we have conquered our unrivaled enemies. Therefore, we have no fear touching death. Even Narayana and Rudra, Sakra and Yama ever fear to stay before us in the field of battle. And, O Lord of Rakshasas, there is no occasion for Vishnu's displeasure of us. The mind of Vishnu hath wavered in consequence of the evil caused by the celestials. Therefore, will we even avenge ourselves on the gods from whom hath sprung this wrong? Having taken counsel together, those powerful ones conciliated their forces, and proclaiming their order that preparations were to be made, all the foremost Nairithas sallied forth for battle, like unto those led by Jamba and Vritra. And, O Rama, having thus taken counsel together with all the preparations made, those huge-bodied and redoubtable Rakshasas marched forth for conflict, mounted on cars and elephants and horses resembling elephants, and mules and kine and camels and porpoises and serpents, makaras and tortoises and fishes and fowls, resembling Garuda himself, lions and tigers and boars and Srimaras and Chamaras. And puffed up with the pride of prowess, the Rakshasa army, leaving Lanka and the enemies of the celestials, went to the heavenly regions for battle. And perceiving the destruction of Lanka at hand, those deities that had taken up their quarters there, everywhere were struck with fear and felt their spirits depressed. And mounting the best of cars, the Rakshasas by hundreds and thousands with intent minds swiftly sallied forth for the celestial regions. And the deities followed the track of the Rakshasas. And at the command of Kala, terrible evil omens foreshadowing the destruction of the Rakshasa chiefs began to rise on the earth as well as in the sky. The clouds showered down bones and hot blood. The oceans overlapped the continents,
and the mountains shook.
The jackals of terrible forms, having voices resembling the roaring of clouds, bursting out into a hoarse laugh, began to emit cries frightfully. Creatures, one after the other, were seen to drop down. Mighty swarms of vultures, with mouths belching forth flames, began to wheel over the Rakshasa like unto Kala himself. And blood-footed pigeons and sarikas darted off ground. And crows and two-legged cats began to cry in loud accents. But fast bound with the noose of death, the Rakshasas, proud of their strength, disregarding these omens, marched on and did not stay their course. Malivan and Sumali, possessed of prodigious strength, going before the Rakshasas like flaming fires. And even as the gods take refuge under Dhata, the night rangers take refuge under Malivan, resembling the mountain Malivan. And under the command of Mali, the host of Rakshasas, roaring like mighty clouds, inspired with the desire of victory, went to the celestial regions. And the Lord Narayana, hearing of the preparations of the Rakshasas from a celestial messenger, set his heart on fight. And equipped with weapons and quivers, he mounted on Vinata's offspring, that is Garuda. And donning on his mail furnished with the effulgence of 1,000 suns, fastening his spotless quivers filled with shafts, being engirt with his waistband and bright falchion, and equipped with his conch, discus, mace, shranga, sword, and other superior weapons, that lotus-eyed lord, seated on Garuda like a very mountain, set out speedily for the destruction of the Rakshasas. And seated on Suparna's back, that blue-brown Hari, clad in yellow attire, resembled a mass of clouds on the crest of the golden mountain, with lightning playing through it. And hemmed by Siddhas and Celestials and Sages and Uragas and Gandharvas and Yakshas, the enemy of the Asura hosts presented himself, bearing in his hands the discus sword, that weapon Shranga, and the conch. And the Rakshasa hosts, struck by the wind produced by the wings of Suparna, with their pennons swinging to and fro and their weapons scattered about, quaked with the blue summit of a mountain with its crags tossed about. Then the night rangers, hemming in Madhava, began to pierce him with thousands of excellent sharpened weapons, dyed in flesh and blood and resembling the fire of doomsday.
மங்களம் கோஷ்லேந்திராய மகனிய குணாப்தே சக்கரவர்த்தி தனுர்ஜாய சர்வபௌமாய மங்களம்.